I'm Linda. Today I had a funny little conversation with a good friend of ours. And it went something like this. He said, you know, one day all the wives are going to realize when they're in heaven with their husbands, they're going to realize that their husbands are perfect. And I said, yeah, it's going to take eternity for them to become perfect. After a couple years in purgatory, they'll finally be perfect.
I know.
Nobody's perfect, at least not until heaven.
I think sometimes we wish that we were. Maybe some of you think that you are. I probably have the opposite kind of mentality compared to many people. I'm supremely aware of my imperfection. In fact, I probably have the opposite problem where I focus too much on my imperfection. But it's an odd thing, this idea of perfection, because this side of eternity, we probably won't achieve it outside of our relationship in Christ. But we're striving for that. The thing about it is that along the way, in the relationships that we've been given, we have to learn to love people, including ourselves, in our imperfection.
That's hard, because I want things perfect. You know, it's easy for me to recognize my own imperfections, to be okay with my own imperfections, and not so easy maybe to accept Chris's imperfections, or the imperfections of my children, or the imperfections of the lady checking out my groceries, you know, at the store. That it's so easy to pick them apart and say, my gosh, they're so slow, or why are they talking so much? We want to nitpick on their imperfections too. And so it's hard to be patient with somebody else's imperfections, but thank goodness God's patient with my imperfections.
I think ultimately, like, our ministry is a ministry of imperfection. We always like to say that we like people who are messy. We love messy people. And I think the older that you get, the more you realize that you could have done things a different way, or maybe should have, like, for example, investing. That would have been a good idea to do. But the thing about imperfection is that it's kind of a reminder of our need. And most people don't like that. They don't like to be reminded that you need, that we need. Especially in Western civilization, America, we have such a propensity to exaggerate things and to feel like that we have everything and that we don't need anyone's help. We're afraid of things like codependency. So there's this like bravado and maybe an overconfidence. But in relationships, for a relationship to function, not just survive even, but to thrive, you have to be willing to acknowledge, here's my imperfection. And to be loved, even though you're imperfect, is an amazing gift, an incredible witness. And this is an old reference, and forgive me for this. Most of you won't remember this, but there was a TV show called Family Ties, and I loved it. It had Michael J. Fox is a young man, and his parents, they had a conversation in the kitchen in this television show that I'll never forget. And the husband was bemoaning the fact that basically maybe he wasn't perfect, and that she'd been in conversation with someone from an old high school scenario. And finally she stopped the whole conversation and she said, you know, I'm not waiting for you to be something else. Like, I love you as you are. And I, even to this day, I remember like that idea of, it's not like she was waiting for him to become something different for her to love him. I probably did that episode an injustice, but the way it's stuck in my brain has been a beautiful thing, that to be loved in our imperfection is an amazing gift. It brings peace and consolation when you're propensity maybe is being neurotic.
Now, just because we love a person in their imperfection doesn't mean that we have to allow really bad situations to continue, though, either. And that even though I know he loves me in my imperfection, ultimately I need to improve. I need to be a better person for him. I need to love him better. And the same with him. In order for I to love him in his imperfections, but he should strive to be better as well, to be more perfect. Perfection is just impossible, really. But we should strive towards that. So, but I do want to give that little bit of warning that just because you love a person, that it's okay to help work towards the betterment of that person. And sometimes that's tough love. Sometimes it requires some extra help or some seriously difficult choices. But
I think it's still... like this was an imperfect transition.
That's okay.
But I think it's kind of like loving someone in their imperfection is the starting point in which relationships can grow and into.
And it's a safe, that's the safe place where change can occur. When a person understands that they're loved despite their difficulties, despite their struggles, that's the safety net for them to be able to make those choices and feel better.
So if you see something in a person that you love, you want to first make sure that you've laid the foundation of, I love you unconditionally no matter what, in your imperfection. And then from that, you can build and grow and talk about things that sometimes can be difficult. Linda's had to have many of those conversations with me. Anyway, we love you and are grateful for you. And even though you're imperfect, we want you to know that we're okay with that. We like messy people.